Don't you often feel that, what are the reasons why some businesses are become successful and some are not? So today's video, I'm going to discuss with you a topic it's a very important topic, and this is one of the reasons why a business can be successful. And if it is not maintained well, then a business can even fail. So this is a very important topic, and stay tuned till end. And if you have any comment, please comment in the below. And if you are not subscribed till yet, please subscribe to my channel. So without wasting much time, let's jump into my mind map. So the topic is customer loyalty. I think many of you already know what is customer loyalty, but to let you know overall, I will take you what is customer loyalty, some biggest customer loyalty program. I will only mention in India so that you can relate more, but apart from that, there are lot of good worldwide, more popular customer loyalty programs are there. But in this video, I will mention some of the Indian customer loyalty program. The third one I will discuss why it is important. And the fourth one I will mention, which is most important, that is how you can increase customer loyalty for your business. So I hope this video will be very useful. Get a pen and paper. Whatever you learned, you write it down, and please comment in the comment box, so that whenever a new person visits the video, they can read the comment and they can understand that what can be the takeaway from this video. And if you write, it will be good for you also. So without wasting much time, and I sorry for my throat. I mean my voice, because I am having little bit of cold and cough today. So the first is customer loyalty. So as most of you know, that customer loyalty is kind of a customer's commitment to your brand. So why a customer will be committed to your brand only, because there are many reasons of customers being not committed to your brand. Because maybe if you are if your business lies into a perfect competition market, like most of the businesses, then customer will have lot of choices. Customer can choose depending on price, customer can choose depending on quality, customer can choose depending on availability. So customer's commitment is very difficult for a business. So a loyal customer will always choose you over your competitor. So how even that can be possible, that is what we are going to discuss in today's video. So it may be, the reason may be excellent customer service, reason may be unbeatable product selection, or any other ways. So let's go to the next topic, that is some so now let us know what are the some popular customer loyalty program in India. So the first one is Jet Privilege. I think Jet Mile, Jet Privilege, all of you know that when Jet first introduced this Jet Privilege, it became hugely popular. And the frequent flyer used to choose over used to choose Jet over the other airline because of this Jet Mile or Jet Privilege. So that was huge popular and huge successful customer loyalty program for Jet. Then the next is Amazon Prime, which is a biggest success for Amazon, because when Amazon started this Amazon Prime, it was facing a big competition from Flipkart in Indian market. So when India Amazon launched Amazon Prime, it got huge success, because you can also understand, because suppose you are an Amazon Prime customer, and because of Amazon Prime already you have paid a very nominal amount at the beginning of the year. Amazon is giving you so much added advantage, free delivery, you are able to watch those Prime videos, whatever the content, the OTT content, and also I think Amazon Music is free for you. So there are so many benefits Amazon is giving. But apart from that, what you are thinking while ordering a thing from Amazon over the other e-commerce platform is that delivery is free, you will get the thing from the same day or maybe the next day. So there are many benefits to the Prime customer what Amazon is offering you, and as you have already paid once, so you will always prefer to buy from Amazon. So this, by launching this Amazon Prime, Amazon actually forcing you to become loyal to them. So that is the benefit of customer loyalty program. So the next is Payback. I think Payback points also, maybe 6-7 years back or 10 years back, it was hugely popular. Whenever you do any online transaction, we used to get some points in our Payback card. But now I think that is not very popular, because most of the credit card, they started their own this point system. But that time, I think 10-12 years back, when Just Payback launched, that time it was huge success. Then last I mentioned is Titan also, they have their points. Whenever you will buy anything from Tata, I think you will get some credit points in your Titan card, and that points you can redeem whenever you can, like there will be a substantial point in your card, you can redeem it in your next purchase. So those are few examples, but nowadays you can see more and more customer loyalty program with many brands. So most of the brands, they understood that retaining a customer is very important. So most of them launched those customer loyalty program. So again, the next topic is why it is important. So as I was already mentioning, that retaining a customer is very important. As per some study done by Bain & Co, the consultant, the management consultant Bain, they said that actually loyal customer spend 67% more than the other customer. And also we also know that, getting a customer, the customer acquisition cost is very high in this current era. Because you have to spend in advertisement, you have to spend in marketing, you have to spend lot of other ways to first acquire a customer. So if you see the customer acquisition cost of all those new e-commerce platform, it is very, very high. They are offering very lucrative offer to attract your attention so that you can buy first time. And every e-commerce, every new startup, you will see that they will offer a huge discount or some other benefit if you buy for the first time. So that is called customer acquisition cost, and mostly it is very high. So whenever if a company cannot retain a customer in their platform, it's a huge loss for a company. So that is the importance of having a customer loyalty program. And if your customer are loyal to you, then your profit, obviously you will get a higher profit. So that is why it is important. The next is very important, that is how can you increase your customer loyalty. So the very first point I would say is be clear about your core values. So in my another video, I think last week I have recorded, so there I mentioned that what are the importance of mission, vision and core values. So core values are very important because customer will see that what are the values of your company, and now that customer has lot of choice. So customer will always prefer a company which has high values, which actually prefer customer over the other thing like profit or any other thing. So now I think you would see that most of companies, they have their core values. And whenever a customer, suppose I'm just giving an example of Amazon. So Amazon is a very, very customer centric company, and that is why Amazon grows. Amazon has got this exponential growth, and that is how Amazon actually established so quickly. Like in 10 years, Amazon has become world number one online retailer or e-commerce platform. So that is the reason, because they have their core values, that they are customer centric company. That is their topmost core values, which a customer actually value, and that is why customer is ordering repeatedly. The next is always be honest and transparent. So Amazon is a very, very big company, but when you start small, you have to be honest and transparent with your customer. Suppose the first customer of yours, that is very important for your business. And the first few customer, if you can retain them, if you can get a repetitive order from them, then I think your business it will be successful. So becoming honest and transparent always help you to connect with your customer better. The third is under promise and over deliver. So generally most of the companies in current social media era and kind of sales driven companies, what they do is they always over promise and under deliver. But mostly when you under promise and over deliver, that is what customer will actually connect with you very quickly. So suppose I am ordering something from I just want to order something from an e-commerce platform, and suppose I have ordered I am very price sensitive customer, and I saw that this item is cheaper in some new e-commerce platform over Amazon, but still I will think twice that if the difference is like 5-7%, I will still rather buy from Amazon over some new e-commerce platform. Why? Because of their values, I know that if something happens to the product, they will not ask me second time to take it back or give me a refund. So why I will take risk to buy from a new e-commerce platform? So that is, and that is another reason that day by day it is becoming difficult to for a newcomer, new businesses to stand out from the very big businesses, because they have so many loyal customers. So if you under promise and over deliver, and your customer feel that, though it is, suppose you are like, many times it happened to me that I bought some product which is non-returnable, and something I didn't like it, or some defective product got delivered, and I called customer care, and then they immediately gave me the refund. But that may not happen for a company which maybe they just over promised and under delivered. So that is one thing you have to keep in mind, that maybe for that product you may have to suffer a loss, but if you can retain the customer, so I think that would be ultimately a profit figure for you. So that also another thing you have to keep in mind. The fourth is, build your authority in your positioning. So what is that? Let me explain. So build your authority means you have to be known for that product or service. So you are an authoritative figure for your product or service, whatever you are offering. So from the day one, it is not possible. You have to put effort consistently to build that brand. And brand building itself is a big big subject to know, to explore, so that I will not cover in this. But if you want to be known for your product, then you have to give a product which is like, even if you cannot compete with price, maybe 5% more, but you should not compromise for your product value. So that is one thing. So you have to build authority for your positioning. The next point is, know what your customer wants. So suppose because as a new business, you are catering to a very small amount of people, and if you can know that what your customer really wants, then you can actually better serve them. So how you can do that? There are so many n number of ways for that. For that I have to maybe I will make a separate video, but knowing your customer is very important to convert your customer as a loyal customer. Treat your employees better than customer. This is very important point which most of the business person actually they don't implement that part, because they feel that customer is king. But remember, who are the front face of your company? Those are the employees. Maybe when you are starting small, you are the front face, but as soon as you start growing, you have to keep one or two people, and maybe that from 1, 2, 10, 100. So those employees will be the front face for your company, and if you are not taking care of your employees, then they will not take care of your customer. So that is very important, and this aspect is, I have seen many small businesses, they actually don't implement, and that is why they can't retain the good employees. So that's a big chapter, but still in this video also I wanted to mention that treat your employee better than your customer, and then only your employees will treat your customer the way you want to treat them. So that is very important. The next is, ask for feedback. So generally most of us, if you feel that as a customer we are not very much, most of the time we are reluctant to give feedback, but at least as a business person you should ask for feedback. So maybe 10% will give you feedback, but still it will be a good amount of feedback you will get, and depending on that feedback you can improve your product and service, whatever you are offering. So ask for feedback is very important. Then the next is, build testimonial. So if you ask for testimonial, then only customer will give. That is the first thing. Second thing is, when you ask for testimonial, that will be a big that will help to build your brand. So ask for testimonial, record it, and then when a new customer will come and they will see that you have a bunch of customers who are very happy with you, they will definitely want to buy your product or service. So that is what all those e-commerce platforms are doing. They are getting the feedback of customers so that their overall sales can grow. So that is the next point. The ninth point is, provide additional value. So value. So this is the era where you have to, you are facing a big amount of competition. So how you can differentiate from your competitor? By providing good value, what your customer wants. I'm not telling that providing a value which actually is not required by your customer. So whatever your customer is asking, you have to give that value. And if you are giving that additional value, then only you can differentiate yourself from your competitor. And the last but not the least is reward customer for their loyalty. So that is the customer loyalty program which many companies are offering nowadays. So just as a small business owner, if you can think of some customer loyalty program, just think and just implement that. So just think what you are offering to your customer, so that customer will choose next time you. One thing is obviously the quality of product or service you are delivering, but still, if a newcomer also will come, why should a customer choose you? So if you can share some of your profit, some of anything, like any offering you can give to your customer as a customer loyalty, I think customer can stick to you better. So those are my 10 tips to convert your customer as a loyal customer. I hope you can implement those points, at least, maybe not all 10, at least 4, 5, 6. Even if you implement 4, 5, 6 points, I think you will see a good amount of loyal customer in your customer base. If that happens, please come back to video and comment below that I have implemented some of your points and got result. I'll be very happy to read those comments, obviously, because I am also taking some effort to record this video and putting in the YouTube. And if you want a clarity in your business strategy so that you can create a growth strategy for your business, you can book a special one-to-one call. The link is mentioned below. In the first few every month I am offering free of cost, and you may get a free one-to-one session. Please please click the below mentioned link and you can book a free one-to-one session. Hope you like this video. If yes, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you. Bye bye.